The Linwood Icehouse Museum is the story of a community working together over many years to save a lovely old structure from destruction.
Good evening. Tonight we're going to welcome Rachael Walsh. She's going to talk about the history of Linwood and the Ice House. So I'm going to let her go ahead and start talking.
Okay. Thanks everyone for coming out. All right, well, first off, is anyone familiar with Linwood? Has anyone ever been there? So you have some idea of where it stands on the bay, kind of right here. Great fishing, rough weather, though. So part of the story of our little building is that it survived over 100 years out there on the bay. And it's a story of victory in a community, people working together over many years, working together. Say something. So this is our Linwood Icehouse Museum. The people who bought the property were going to tear down the ice house also, but the community decided to save it and turn it into a little museum in the village. This was a craftsman style. And so that's what we were supposed to experience. Now, we did not save that too well. We had to rebuild it, but that was a joyous moment to get to save it instead of see it torn down.
During the time between saving the building and restoring the structure, we have collected historic artifacts and local history and established a research library, beginning with the definitive Linwood history publication by Pat Drury and Ron Bloomfield of Bay City.
A granddaughter living north of Linwood received these diaries in the mail from an aunt who wanted them to come back to Bay County. She was in California. Mm-hmm. And this dear woman named Esther Dunning, living on Kitchen Road, read them to her father. He was one of the sons of the diarist. And he wept because it brought back so many memories of how difficult the times were. Mm-hmm. And when she relatives wanted to borrow this volume or that volume, Esther Dunning wouldn't let them go. She brought them to the museum. The director called people together and she said, we have all these things that need somebody paying attention to them. And as she went down the list, she got to the Myra Parsons diaries, and I found myself thinking, I hope nobody else raises his or her hand. Oh, I think I should work on Myra. So I started by reading the diaries. I was just overwhelmed at the vividness and the detail of this frontier woman's experience. I started transcribing. It took a couple of years, and a friend helped me proofread it. I then went through and I worked out the major themes, the medical care she gave in the community, including delivering babies. She moved to the area in 1876. Her husband, Malin, went out to clean out the ice house, and the 2nd of January, 1877, four loads of ice had come in. In 1882, January, they decided it would be a wonderful idea to develop a little village along Town Line Road, between Fraser and Kaukauna townships. And in December of the same year, they had been accepted by the state, the surveyor had come, the population was about 238 people. They had done that all in 1 year.
Pat's book is available through the Bay County Historical Society in Bay City, Michigan.